was chasing after it, went behind the net. Here got a chunk of Pollock. Wrong shot is going to be held by Mason.
And now we've got Peters in another battle. Peters is going at it again. Second fight of the night. And this time with Janssen. Janssen and Peters. It was Kochi, the first opponent. And now Janssen and Peters tosses a right in there, right on the bunker. And another one. Janssen is just biding his time, trying to get his elbow pads off. And Peters got another right in. Peters lost his helmet with that blow, and now he labels them again. Janssen and Peters. Second fight for Andrew Peters in this period. And he's back Janssen all the way to the corner, and now they start exchanging blows again. And Peters fires another right that connects. And Janssen comes back with a weak right, then he gets a better one in. And the officials are still standing back, and Peters now drills a couple of rights in there. As they make their way all the way over to the boards, and the linesmen are going to get in there. And I got a question for Rob Ray. How tough is that on Andrew Peters, your second fight of the period?
I'll tell you, two fights in a game is very difficult, and I give Andrew an awful lot of credit because he was patient in that fight. He didn't try to go at him. He didn't try to get the upper hand real quick. He sat back, waited for his opportunities because he knew he wasn't in the condition that, you know, Janssen's was. He has not been in a fight. So, hey, he had a little limited energy. So he did it smart. He showed an awful lot of patience, and he did very well in that one too, guys. Yeah. Two in a row.
And Andrew Peters, of course, has been in and out of the lineup all year long. You think that upsets him?
No, it does. No.
Hang on a sec. It does not upset him. Not whatsoever. Listen.
I'm the luckiest guy in this world, and I've said it a million times. I have a brother who's in the minors and battling there for 10, 11 years. He's never played in the NHL, so I can't ever forget that.